Hello, YouTube. No graphics, no music, no get your attention beginnings. Just mono a mono. Something happened here a little bit ago, and tonight I was Skyping with Photohelix. We were talking back and forth, and I told him about something that happened here recently, and he emphatically told me that I needed to put this to video. I told him I put it on Facebook and all. And so he said, "You got to do a video on this." I said, "All right, I'll think about it." And I prayed about it. And so let me tell you what happened. And this is on the 26th of September. I had called in sick from work. I was having a bad chest cold going on, and I'm laying on the couch and I'm sleeping, and I awoke from a dream, and I had the most horrific, bone-chilling God chills. I was overwhelmed with the emotions from the dream, but I couldn't physically see the dream, if you know what I mean. I couldn't remember the dream like that. But all of the emotions that went on with it, and horrified I was. And I sat up, and please don't condemn me, because this is what happened. I do smoke, not on screen, no. And I went to have a cigarette, and I had the overwhelming feeling that I was supposed to put this out. And I didn't know, so I opened up Facebook and I hit post, and what I'm about to read to you poured out of me in like 5 minutes. It all came out, and I posted it, and I'm going to read to you what came out. And I've been overwhelmed by this whole thing over the past few days because of what today actually is, and we'll get into that in a minute. Let me read you what I wrote. Okay, pay attention to what I'm about to say. I will try not to be long-winded. So I am sure you know about the chemtrailing that has been going on for many, many years. What they are spraying along with the aluminum, the barium, the strontium, and other vaporized metals, they are also spraying nanoparticulates, i.e., nanobots. These microscopic computer-based machines are in the air you breathe, the food you eat, the water you drink and bathe in, all of it. In other words, every human being on the planet, you and me included, have these nanobots throughout our bodies. These nanobots have the ability to rewrite your DNA. This is the mixing of iron and clay. Yahweh told Moses he would put his words in an earthen vessel. We are that earthen vessel. Science tells us that we use about 10% of our DNA that makes us, well, us. The other 90% is what they have classified as junk DNA. And in actuality, the junk DNA is not junk, but rather the words of God written in us. Now you can understand what Christ Yeshua meant when he said his words will never pass away. Yes, the Mandela slash quantum effect is changing the Bibles and reality around us, may I add. But the words of God are still safe within his temple. Once again, that temple is us. Now back to the nanobots. These nanobots are inside us all, just sitting dormant. Right now, globally, they are building these 5G towers and installing these smart meters at a radical pace, globally. The reason for this is because the mark of the beast is very nearly ready to be implemented. When that time comes, whosoever takes that chip will be transformed. The chip will receive its instructions from these 5G towers and smart meters connecting you to the global network, turning you into a hive mind. And the chip will activate these nanobots inside you, which will rewrite your junk DNA. And it ain't junk. The words of Yahweh within you will have become corrupted, and you will have effectively and permanently become clay mixed with iron. At this time, the prophecy of Daniel will have been fulfilled. He, Satan slash the beast, will be standing in the place where he ought not to be. You will have effectively removed God from the throne of God within you and replaced him with Satan. Even if you could dig the chip out of your head or hand, it just does not matter because the chip has done its purpose and changed your DNA permanently. Satan will be sitting in the temple of God, you, declaring himself God, the fourth beast, different from all the others. The statue from Daniel, the toes, mixed of iron and clay. We are here, people. Tribulation is starting. As in the days of Noah, the Nephilim. Scripture states that there is nothing new under the sun. What has been done before will be done again. Now listen closely. When you receive that chip and they put that into you, these 5G towers are going to be transmitting, and that chip is going to pick up that signal. Now, today I was watching a video that Richie from Boston put out, talking about the absolute horrible Wi-Fi signal where he was on his national trip that we've all been watching. And people go, well, what about those people? Because they're not getting that Wi-Fi signal. And there we are, the smart meters, because even they got them. And you got to understand, let's just say like Truthstream Media just put out a video about their adventures about getting that smart meter taken off their house and an analog one put on there, which is good because these meters, they are a two-way communication with the electric grid. Okay, they send information out and they receive information, and then they send pulses out, 8 to 9 pulses per minute throughout your whole house. These pulses, these frequencies, that chip that's in your right hand or in your forehead is going to get that signal. You pull it off your house, fine, you're not getting the signal in your house. But when you leave your house and you go to drive down the street, every house has one. You go to work, they're all over the place at work. You go out to dinner with your wife or your girlfriend, you're getting bombarded. You all decide you're going to go out dancing somewhere, have a couple drinks and go dancing. You're getting bombarded with these smart meters, along with the 5Gs, so they've got everything covered. There's no way of getting away from the signal. Now, for those of you that don't get that chip, those nanobots sit dormant with no instruction, no rewrite of your DNA. God's word is preserved within you. Do you understand that? As God told Moses, I will put my words in an earthen vessel. You are that earthen vessel. The words of God are written in your DNA. So it doesn't matter how many changes in the quantum Mandela effect, whatever you want to say, how much your Bible is changing. The words of God are preserved in his temple. You, but those of you that take that mark, Whoa, whoa, whoa to you. I'm telling you, people, wake up. And continue. Do you understand that? You know, we've been barraged with a deluge of videos posting, this is it. The rapture's here. We're going to get whisked away. And the 23rd came and went. And a bunch of recalculations came out. Oh, it's a jubilee, so the last trump is being blown on Day of Atonement, September 30th. Here we are. And in the immortal words of Morpheus from The Matrix, we are still here. So now the latest thing that's come out is the big declaration that they did last year and the year before, that the Hebrew calendar and the Gregorian calendars, they're all off by a month. People, I want you to listen closely when I say this. If the calendars are off by a month, then we need to go back through even just recent history to the Balfour Declaration, to the blood moon, to Israel's declared a nation. The blood moons especially, pay attention, the blood moons of 49 and 50, the blood moons of 67 and 68, the blood moons of 2014 and 2015, the Star of Bethlehem that appeared in 2015, the eclipse, and the Revelation 12 sign. Every single one of those signs in the heavens is off by a month, which means now the blood moons mean nothing. The eclipse meant nothing. Star of Bethlehem meant nothing. You've totally taken away the meaning of the signs to fit your new rapture date. When I take a look at the calendars and how they match the signs in heaven, I can only conclude one thing. The signs are right, the calendars are right, and you're wrong. This has been a quick edit. I had to throw this in because I forgot that I didn't put that in. I went, you know, that needs to be said. Let's continue. The Revelation 12 sign was not about the rapture. You don't take into account the eclipse, the 33 days to the Revelation 12 sign, the complete 40 days, the last week, the days of awe, of repentance, leading to Day of Atonement, as in the sign of Jonah. This was all about one thing. And I understand that it's hard to wrap your mind around this when you've believed in the pre-trib rapture all your life so much. And now all the evidence says that theory was incorrect. Tribulation has started. What I just read to you is happening. Things are going to get crazy. The horror that I felt when I woke up, and although I don't see the dream, I know what the dream was about and what came out of me and what I was being shown. This is happening, people. The things that you've been seeing on TV, that company, I think it was Wisconsin, where get the chip in their hand and they were putting it in the left hand, not the right. Gee, I wonder why. Because that wasn't the actual mark of the beast, but it was an introduction to it to get you accustomed to it. This is coming. The events that are going to lead up to this, I don't know. God didn't make me a prophet to tell you what thus says what he says is going to happen. He made me a watchman on the wall to tell you what's happened, what's happening, and what all of the signs are pointing to is to what is about to happen. Wake up. If you're not a Christian and you're still with me on this, there's a next part of this video that I want you to watch. If you are a Christian, watch it too and strengthen spiritually from it. Wake up, folks. Things are about to get really, really, really horribly bad beyond anything you can possibly imagine. Scripture talks about how bad it's gonna get. Watchman on the wall, sound the word. If you're not a Christian, repent. Accept Christ. Open up the Bible. Look me up on Facebook, Paul Adams. Picture don't look much different other than I don't have the beard, just the mustache with, you know, going down. Pick my picture from my channel. I ask you to share this video. This word's got to get out, man. Peace, love y'all, and good night.
Are you hurting and broken within? Overwhelmed by the weight of your sin? Jesus is calling. Have you come to the end of yourself?
Just